Mr. Speaker, we need to address certain things in this country. The Nigerian youth, the social media influencers, and the social media. But first of all, let me condemn the Lekki massacre. Mr. Speaker, these are youths like me who came out to ask for their fundamental human right, life, nothing but life. Mr. Speaker, all they could get from a country they love so much was death, with blood stained on the flag. Mr. Speaker, this is a dishonor to national integrity and makes me wonder which system of government is Nigeria practicing. Mr. Speaker, vis-a-vis this inhumane carnage across the nation, it's worth asking who made the order, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, we all know that the military is supposed to defend the country against external aggression. So we would like to know, the parents would like to know, the youth would like to know who unleashed the military against her citizens, causing a lot of deaths in a democratic era, Mr. Speaker. The looters who hijacked the peaceful protests are children we refuse to give educational empowerment. Mr. Speaker, now they are grown. A lot of them are paid thugs, causing violence in every peaceful environment, Mr. Speaker. On this note, we would like justice to be served, and also the parents, the families of the deceased peaceful protesters to be compensated. Also, Mr. Speaker, I would like to commend the Nigerian celebrities and social media influencers for using their platform to place Nigeria on a golden spotlight globally and also championing the cause for a better Nigeria. Mr. Speaker, the social media has its positive and negative impact, yes, but the Nigerian youth have decided to use their social media handles to air their grievances on the poor state of the nation, which they have not been privileged to do decades ago due to poor state of technological advancement, Mr. Speaker. On this note, I want to commend Nigeria for that. Their voices have been heard, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, it is no more news that Nigeria is the poverty capital of the world. Ironically, our leaders are the richest in the world of politics. Mr. Speaker, it is a shame that while we live in affluence, the people we are living in abject poverty. On this note, I stand here as the voice of the youth. Mr. Speaker, I'm here as one of the few youth surviving in a gerontocratic system of government where oligarchy is the order of the day. Mr. Speaker, to alleviate the poverty in our nation, I would like to implore all office holders that every money allocated to each constituency should be duly utilized to alleviate the poverty in our nation. Also, Mr. Speaker, without history, the future will be at stake. We need to go back to our drawing board and restructure the country's policy. If not, leadership will be baseless. For this reason, I would like us, Mr. Speaker, to go back to the constitution drafted before independence, the peaceful constitution. And I assure you, when this is done, in the next 5 years, Nigeria will be the cynosure of the world, and she will reclaim her title as the giant of Africa, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, as I speak to you, Nigeria is one of the countries with the worst healthcare facilities in the world. This has resulted in our elites traveling abroad for medical attention. Mr. Speaker, how long do we allow our people to die due to low medical facilities in the country? For this reason, Mr. Speaker, I would like to implore the government that we should build state-of-the-art hospitals across the nation and also prohibit our leaders and their children from traveling, including me, Mr. Speaker. Let's stay here and build our nation. If you don't build our nation, who will, Mr. Speaker? Let's stay here. And if we decide that we will not build good hospitals for our children, good hospitals for ourselves, let's stay here. We die here, Mr. Speaker. And for the youths, the only way to change the government is through your PVC 2023 with MUV. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.